Jonnie was born September 21st.
Healthy pregnancy, healthy birth. Jonnie fell ill with a respiratory illness. We took him to the hospital. A resident noticed that Jonnie had a heart murmur. They found that he had multiple aneurysms in his heart, as well as a hole in his heart called a PDA. 3 months after his initial illness, we went in for a checkup and found out that Jonnie was in heart failure from the hole in his heart. And they said, we need to close this immediately. They were able to close it. It was successful. Over time, he just kept not meeting milestones and he kept not developing like everyone thought he should.
We didn't understand why he was facing all these challenges.
We were going to the hospital every week or every other week. After a couple of years, someone recommended we have him genetically tested to see if we could find a more detailed diagnosis about what was going on.
It was a little scary to think about what could be uncovered, but at the same time, I was expecting some relief from maybe an understanding of what was happening and then a treatment plan around that answer.
They did a lot of genetic counseling with us. They really educated us on what the possibilities were from this choice about finding an answer, but that not necessarily providing a treatment or a cure, or not finding anything. We did the sequencing where they sequenced Johnny's DNA as well as Drew and I's, and then they just prepped us to wait for several months because it can take a really long time to get that back. The genetic department called us in and said, we have the diagnosis MSMDS, which is multisystemic smooth muscle dysfunction syndrome. It's considered an ultra rare smooth muscle disease. There are around 50 diagnosed people worldwide, mostly children.
Everything we'd been chasing down started to make sense based on that diagnosis, so that did bring some answers.
They said immediately, you need to go see Dr. Chatfield at Children's Hospital in Colorado. She's a genetic cardiologist, and she's basically going to be Johnny's doctor for the rest of his life.
We probably had 7 or 8 different doctors that we were seeing, and we never really knew who would take ownership of a decision because of genetic testing. That doctor became Dr. Chatfield.
And yeah, we call her the queen.
Yeah, I think that was a positive outcome for sure.
She's a doctor in genetics as well as a doctor in pediatric cardiology. She's highly specialized and knowledgeable. Even though there are only 50 cases diagnosed worldwide, 3 of them are at Children's and she treats all of them. So when we went to see her, she already knew what we were talking about. When Johnny received his genetic diagnosis, we were able to access a lot more specialized clinicians, clinics, and care at Children's. They were kind of able to preemptively put us in the care of clinicians where we could proactively care for Johnny. It changed our life, and it changed Johnny's life.
How's he doing now in life?
I mean, I would say he's living his very best life.
You wanna see my most valuable Lego?
Yes.
This one. It's an Optimus Prime that transforms. This is a book that I made.
It's hopeful to watch Johnny experience life.
That was old Haley.
And his determination just to live life as a kid.
My hope for him is that he gets to experience as many opportunities as he would want